ENF Mylar Kitty Coasters are like the kids menu. Sure, they're meant for kids, but sometimes you just want to eat chicken nuggets. That sounded better in my head. Basically, Kitty Coaster have airtime.
I'm gonna rank every coaster and give them a review. Every drop and every hill, every launch and every loop. Rate it 1 to 10 and then we'll do it all again. Gonna rank and review every coaster.
What's going on, everybody? My name is Mario. This is a channel all about amusement park type stuff, but mostly coasters. And today, in my never-ending journey to rank and review every single coaster I have ever been on, we're gonna be talking about ENF Mylar Kitty Coasters. So the wheel from last episode told me to do a review on Mine Train at Sonoma Train Town, but I didn't feel like there was enough to say on that to warrant its own episode, so I decided to just combine all ENF Mylar Kitty Coasters into one video. And real quick, I just wanted to say thank you to those of you that are subscribed to this channel. You guys are awesome. And to anybody that's not subscribed, you better subscribe, or ENF Mylar will start making kitty coasters that don't have ejector airtime. And then we'd only be able to ride thrill coasters for our airtime. We don't want that, do we? But without any further ado, let's review. So I have been on 6 ENF Mylar Kitty Coasters. Here they are in order of the date that I first rode them. Freeway Coaster at Adventure City, Sea Serpent at Santa Cruz Beach Boardwalk, Mine Train at Sonoma Train Town, Choo Choo, Little Dipper at Castle Park, Canyon Blaster at Six Flags Magic Mountain, and last, but certainly not least, Ravine Flyer 3, at Waldemere. Now, these ENF Mylar Kitty Coasters are definitely about as small scale as it gets when it comes to roller coasters, but that does not mean that they don't pack a punch. Double negative. Kind of like 2 airtime hills in a row on a kitty coaster. Double negatives, you know, like ejector airtime, negative G-forces. But yeah, that's actually one of the things that is really interesting about these ENF Mylar Kitty Coasters. They are definitely my favorite kitty coasters. That being said, I don't necessarily think they are the best kitty coasters, if that makes any sense. But that's not to say that kids don't still enjoy these. Every single one of these I've ever been on, I've seen little enthusiasts in the making with the biggest smiles ever on their face. So they might not be the most gentle or tame kitty coasters, but I guess that kind of just makes them fun for all ages. In a lot of cases. And also just one last quick thing to mention, all of these coasters, they send you around twice, at least twice, I'm pretty sure. So even though they don't have the longest track length or ride duration, you still get a pretty decent ride out of them. But enough about ENF Mylar in general, let's hop into some of the specifics about each of these individual coasters. So first up, we have Freeway Coaster at Adventure City. Adventure City is a very small amusement park that is designed specifically for kids, so it makes sense that they would have an ENF Mylar Kitty Coaster, and this is one of the weirder ones. It has a relatively nice appearance and some decent theming. It's themed to the freeway. There's also some decent rock work going around it, and each individual car is a different color, so that's kind of fun. As far as the forces on this attraction, it's not the most interesting. It's kind of just wonky and has weird pacing. You kind of fly down the first drop as fast as you can fly down a first drop of a kitty coaster, giving some laterals and even a little bit of airtime in the back. Then you go up a very gentle airtime hill. You very, very slowly go up another hill, slight turn, little drop, big turn, and then a funky little turning airtime hill that also is relatively gentle. So this is definitely a tame ride with the exception of the first drop. And all in all, it's pretty fun and pretty good for the kids. One last weird thing to mention about this ride, the train, or at least the car that I was sitting on the day that I went, the seat is not fully attached to the car. Like, I took my seat and it kind of was shifting around and I was like, what's going on? And then I touched the seat and I realized it didn't feel like it was fully connected to the rest of the car. Yeah, just a little fun fact there, I guess. But moving on. Up next, we're gonna stay in California, but head up north to Santa Cruz Beach Boardwalk for Sea Serpent. There is a lot to like about this coaster. From an off-ride standpoint, the ride looks amazing. You have palm trees, rock work, and even a waterfall. I mean, you think about it, it's kinda like Velocicoaster. I mean, just saying. The front car of this train is themed to a dragon, or a sea serpent rather. So that's always fun to have a cool train design. Now, as far as the on-ride experience goes, this has the most intense airtime of any kiddie coaster I've been on, at least in the back row. And surprisingly, it doesn't come on the first drop. Going through the layout, you have a turning first drop, and then you go up the hill. That gives you the insane airtime in the back. It might also give you that airtime in the front because you do come into it with some speed, but going over that turning airtime hill in the back, you are flung out of your seat. The only thing keeping you in is your lap bar. It's sort of a lap bar, sort of a seat belt. It's like a belt strap that's connected to a bar. Really funky. Anyway, after that airtime hill, you're in somewhat of a helix that goes by the waterfall. You take a dip under that ejector hill, go up another turning hill, one last small turning hill, and then just like that, you're back in the station. So yeah, genuinely a fun roller coaster. It was a great surprise. Two thumbs up for sure. Going even further north in California, up in Sonoma, we have Train Town, which is home to Mine Train. And this is yet another one that surprised me with how much fun it was. Looking at it from off-ride, you see, okay, it's a kiddie coaster. And then you see it going around the course and you're like, okay, it's a pretty fast and kind of whippy kiddie coaster. And then you go on it and you're like, wow, this is actually one of the best kiddie coasters I've ever been on. Aside from the fun helixes and hills that are typical for these ENF Miler kiddie coasters, Mine Train has something very unique and very special. It has a double up that ends with an off-axis airtime hill. No, I'm not making this up. It actually has a trick track double up. Now, it doesn't provide the most aggressive airtime. It does provide better airtime in the front than in the back. But I think the uniqueness of this element alone is enough to make this one of the better coasters on this list and genuinely one of the best kiddie coasters out there. So if you're ever credit hoarding in Northern California and you're looking to snatch up a couple extra credits, I genuinely recommend going to Train Town to check out this coaster. And just the park in general. It's a really beautiful park, aside from this really fun roller coaster. Next up, we have a coaster that actually predates all the other coasters in this video, and was not technically made by ENF Miler, but just Miler Manufacturing, which, without going into the full history of it, is essentially the company that would then turn into ENF Miler. And that coaster is Little Dipper at Castle Amusement Park. This is probably the most tame, therefore the most accessible kiddie coaster on this list, and I think objectively, if you are looking for a coaster that is suitable for small children, this would have to be considered the best kiddie coaster on this list. It really doesn't do anything special. A small turning drop and a couple of hills. Not too thrilling for myself, which is perfectly fine. It is not designed for adults. But one thing that does stand out about this coaster is it has really comfy cushioned seats. So it definitely earns points there. If you're an enthusiast, you're gonna ride this coaster just to add to your coaster count. But if you're a small child, first of all, stop watching YouTube videos unsupervised. And second of all, this coaster will be fun for you. And for our second to last coaster, we're going to be staying in Southern California for Canyon Blaster at Six Flags Magic Mountain. There's a lot of coaster enthusiasts that claim that this thing actually has a really strong ejector, which a lot of ENF Miler kiddie coasters do. But when I rode this, I don't know if it was running slow, which is weird to say about a kiddie coaster. But I was sitting in the back and I didn't really get any airtime. This is definitely one of the tamer kiddie coasters in this video, which does make it a better kiddie coaster in my opinion, but for me personally, not all that fun. And this ride also does have one of the least interesting layouts. It's a turning drop, a helix, and then a couple small airtime hills. So yeah, really good for the little ones. And then last but not least, we're finally leaving California and going to Waldemere for Ravine Flyer 3. While this has an incredibly similar layout to Canyon Blaster at Magic Mountain, this ride is so much more fun, if for nothing else than the setting over the water, and even the pink color scheme is fun. There's not too many pink roller coasters out there. As far as the ride experience goes, it is very similar to Canyon Blaster, with a turning drop, a helix, and some small airtime hills. And yeah, those are the six ENF Miler kiddie coasters that I've been on so far. But now, let's go ahead and rate and rank each of these coasters. First is going to be over rating out of 10 on how good of a kiddie coaster it is. Next is going to be how I rate it for my personal enjoyment. And then I'm going to go ahead and tell you where it lands on my list of coasters that I've been on. So to start off with my least favorite, we have Canyon Blaster. I'd say it's about an 8 out of 10 as far as kiddie coasters go. It is nice and mild, but it is not very interesting, but it at least is not going to freak out any kids that may not be ready for more thrilling roller coasters. And for all those reasons, for myself personally, I'd give it about a 3 out of 10. As far as where this lands on the list of coasters that I've been on, it's currently at number 200 out of 215. Next up is Little Dipper, and this is a slightly more entertaining ride to myself personally, but as far as kiddie coasters go, I'd give this maybe an 8.5 out of 10. I think it's a little more enjoyable, it has more thrill, but it is still very tamed down, and I'd probably give this one another 3 out of 10, although this coaster does rank a little bit better at 190. And just above that, we have Freeway Coaster. I think I'd give Freeway Coaster a 7.5 out of 10 as far as being a good kiddie coaster. It is a little jankier, but it is at least more interesting, which is why I'd probably give this ride a 4 out of 10. If I ever found myself back in that park, I would definitely re-ride it. All that being said, it sits at 191. Now, Ravine Flyer 3 is a little bit better, both as far as being a kiddie coaster and how much I enjoy it. I'd say it is a 9 out of 10 kiddie coaster. It is tame, but it is still fun and exciting. If nothing else, just for the water fountains and water below, I'd also give it a 4 out of 10 for myself personally. And all that puts it at 187. Now we have Sea Serpent, which I mentioned earlier, is probably the most intense kiddie coaster I've been on, or at least it has the most intense airtime. So that's going to give it a relatively low rating of 5 out of 10 for a kiddie coaster. I think it's more along the lines of a family coaster, but for me personally, loving ejector airtime, I would genuinely give this ride a 5.5 or 6 out of 10, somewhere thereabout. I would absolutely ride this again, and I definitely will whenever I get back to Santa Cruz. And since it is so much fun, it sits at 150. And then, saving the best for last, we have Mine Train at Sonoma Train Town. I think it is the most well-rounded coaster out of all of these. It's a pretty decent kiddie coaster. It does have mild forces that are exciting and enjoyable, but would not be off-putting for smaller kids. So I give it a 6 or 7-ish out of 10 for a kiddie coaster. For my personal enjoyment, I'll go ahead and give it a 6 out of 10. I really appreciate the layout and especially that double up element. Super unique. And it's also in a really beautiful park. And all that is going to put it at 145 out of 215. So there you have it. We're finally at the end of this one. Thank you guys so much for watching. It is much appreciated. Let me know if you guys have been on any of these coasters, what your opinions are on ENF Miler kiddie coasters, or just ENF Miler in general. Go ahead and like the video if you liked it. Of course, give it 2 thumbs down if you didn't like it. Subscribe and turn on notifications for more videos like this. And make sure you guys tune in next time where I'll be talking about...